Meat bicycle!
Hello everybody, welcome to The Hunt. So this is the series that I started it a few days ago. I actually just said that I was going to make it, you know, just a little thing for my channel where we just participate in the general rules of The Hunt, but not actually the real thing. But I've actually decided, after releasing that video, and a couple of you guys said that you wouldn't mind actually seeing me do The Hunt. So we are like, well, a couple of weeks in, so we're miles behind everyone. And yeah, I just thought it would be a good idea to actually, you know, just try it out really, see if we can catch up, claw some points together and all that. So yeah, for those of you that don't know what The Hunt is, it's like an intricate farming kind of challenge between, normally it was in Borderlands 2, I think it started off, loads of people did it in there. But this one is actually the number 4, I believe, yes, The Hunt 4, and it's called something like the Handsome Collection Hunt or something like that. So it incorporates Borderlands 1, 2 and the pre-sequel. And yeah, so we're going to go ahead and give it a try, and I've got some good ideas how to claw quite a few points really quickly. So obviously this is Borderlands 1, and what better way to get a load of points than go to the secret armory of General Knox and glitch in and open a shed load of chests. So for you, those of you guys that want to follow me, there is going to be a link in the description for the thread for The Hunt if you want to try it out yourself. And also there's like an intricate point system where you know, you've got certain weapons, like really rare ones will give you 8 to 10 points, quite, you know, common ones will give you 1 maybe 2 points, things like that. So I've got the list here, and yeah, if we're going to find anything, we'll bring it up as well. So I'm going to glitch in now, but basically, you know, the idea is to go through Borderlands 1, 2, and I've been in the wrong spot, Borderlands 1, 2 and 3, collect all the weapons and things like that, and just get as many points as you can. So like I said, the best way to do this is to go to the armory first, and legendaries in Borderlands 1 will give you about, oh, I'd say about 2 points. Obviously pearlescent weapons will be really good as well, but they're going to be really hard to get. So I'm actually going to spend most of this episode in Borderlands 2, because we can go after quite a few easy uniques and get ourselves a few basic points. But yeah, like I said, for now I just want to do one armory run, and you know, legendaries in this game are really quite common, so we should end up picking one or two here, and we'll stop and add our top points up as we go along. And I said they're really common, yet I can't seem to have any while we're in this room, but there are shed load of chests. There we go, straight away we have got ourselves a desert wildcat. So I believe that I could see an orange there as well, see what I mean? This is easy points. So a desert wildcat, and yeah, there you go. So that should be about 2 points already. Is it a Dahl? It's a Dahl wildcat, yes it is. So Dahl wildcat, straight away 1 point, there we go. So I believe I'm full. I don't know if in the rules I have to actually pick it up or not, but there you go. Can I do that? No, talking chat. Yeah, anyway, there you go, 1 point. So I'm gonna actually drop a weapon and anything that I want. I don't need any of these, so let's just drop, I don't know, let's just drop that. There you go, desert wildcat, done. So that's 1 point. So I'm going to drop the wildcat because I'm going to run out of points. Or I'll just drop anything. Well, at the bitch, equalizer, I don't know what to drop. There's another hellfire there. So we'll drop that for our next little legendary over there. If we could find a pearl in here, that would be just amazing. Absolutely amazing. So we've got ourselves a fearsome schoolmasher as well. So that is a Jacobs. So Jacobs schoolmasher, 2 points. There you go, 2 more points. So we've got 3 points already. Like I said, easy points, easy points. So obviously there's going to be a lot more people who are on a lot better than us. Also the iridium guns as well, they all rarities of iridium guns we've got to look out for as well, because they will get us quite a few points as well. So last little section, and then we can go on to the lifts, I believe. There's nothing else here really. No, that's it. Okay, so chest here, come on. Nope, nothing. Right, I'm not going to bother opening them rubbish chests there. I don't think there'll be anything really decent in there, so we'll go to the little lifts. But yeah, hopefully you guys will enjoy this and help me along the way. So I'm basically just going to go for a really easy strategy of actually just going for all the easy ones first. So I mean, like, little things like in Borderlands 2, when we finally get there, the lasso, you can pick that up by just running and picking it up from a pool in Frostburn Canyon. That's an easy point. It's not going to take, you know, there we go, another legendary. Nasty Rebel, that's a Vladoff. I haven't got that up on the list on my screen, and I don't want to click off, so I'll just bring it up on my phone. But I've got them all here now. So it's a Vladoff, Nasty Rebel. Vladoff. Is that on here? Would it just be a Vladoff Red Rebel? I'm not sure. I should really bring this up on... Yep, Vladoff Rebel. Two more points. There we go. 5 points in total. Boom. Let's just drop something else. I really should have sorted out my inventory while I was here. What do I want? Ogre's not bad, actually. There you go. That steel bastard can go. And there is a Nasty Rebel. So that's 3, 4, 5 points already. Nice, nice, nice. I might actually start off nearly every episode with a farmery run as well, because the chances of just getting absolutely loads of legendaries are unreal in this place. Luckily, Borderlands has a really easy way to get legendaries. It's the pearls that take a long time to farm. So hopefully we can pick up one lemon this hunt. Nope, nothing there. Let's get back on it. But yeah, like I said, I'm going to go to Borderlands 2 for most of this. Just pick up some easy uniques, really. I might do some bee farming with the tree ants. That'll be a nice, easy way to get some decent stuff as well. Nothing there. Got a few more of these left. Just got to make sure we get all these crimson ants chests. I think I know where they all are in this. I did do this a long time back in the day. We just spent hours farming the farm. Oh my god! No way! I have not been on this game in years, and I remember taking absolute age to get a pearl, and I've just got one in the first run back. Steel Undertaker. Wow, how many points is that going to give us? Let me check this on the list. There we go. Pearl Essence, Borderlands 1, Undertaker, 8 points straight away. So we've got 13 points in the space of 7 minutes, and I've been talking for about 4 of them. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. I can't believe my luck there. Right, we're getting rid of something very quickly there. There you go. Steel Undertaker. We have a pearl in our first 2 minutes of farming. Oh, thank you, Borderlands 1. Why can't you be like this pre-sequel? Why can't you be like this? Right, we've still got loads to do as well. So I'm just going to have to remind myself how many points I've got here. Oh, that's a thunderstorm. That is a an alien weapon, so to speak. Right, so where will that be in the list? I'm really going to have to just get a print out of this list so I don't have to keep checking on my farm. Let's just put in 13, just so we know for our reference. Iridium, there we go. Thunderstorm. Iridium. Thunderstorm, where will that be? Thunderstorm, 2 more points. There you go. That is 14, 15. Is that 15? I forgot already. I'd say 15. There we go. 15 points. I'm not going to pick that up. I don't think we need to pick them up. We just need to find them and get them on camera. Oh, another legendary. See? Easy points. There we go. We've got a Crux. That is a Maliwan. So, Maliwan Crux, corrosive. That's 2 more points. 17 points now. And we've hardly moved anywhere. Easy, easy, easy. I love this game. I actually love this game. So, there we go. Crux. Another one to add to the list. I'm going to have to write all these down as well at the end of the episode. So, because obviously you only get points for finding something once. You can't, you know, if I find another Crux now, it means nothing. No points for me. But, right, I think that is it for the... I think that is it. Oh, we've got one more. I think we might have one more, actually. Yes, we do. Well, good job I didn't go then. Right, last bit in this. I do like these elevator chest rooms. I must check everything. Oh my god, we're getting legendaries out the head here. Pearl Cyclops. Right, so that is a Atlas. Atlas Cyclops, 2 more points. That's 17 now. I've probably completely messed all of this up. In fact, I've got a pen and paper here. We are putting 17 down so we don't forget. Woo! Right. We are absolutely killing it here. Right, let's move across one and then it'll allow us to get the rest of the farmery done. Farmery. Oh, nearly missed that one as well. Right, can we get an Oh no, I'm not even going to say it. I was going to say, can we get another pearl weapon? But no, I'm not going to say that. I'm happy. We have already got one. What luck. Seriously, what luck. I just remember farming these chests for hours sometimes. Me and my friend, two of us in here, and we were running around, and it took us ages to find pearls. Ages and ages. Right, there's a crimson lance. Let's just stay around here. Are there more iridium weapons? Iridium rifle. Now, is that one that we can count? Because I think we've already got the... what did we already get? We already got a cannon, I think. Well, we'll say I think that might be two more points. Iridium... ball, wave, blaster, fire gun... Splat gun, iridium rifle, 2 points, yeah. We can count that, I think. We can count that. Iridium lightning, is that another one as well? I think that's another one. Iridium lightning, another 2 points. So I believe that's 21 points now. I really should be writing all these down. I'm going to have to go back and watch all these now, because the iridium weapons might come up a lot and I won't know whether I've got them or not. So yeah, right, let's carry on. So I opened a few out here as well. We'll check them in a bit. We'll just end up opening all these. We'll just mass open a load of things so we're not waiting for chests to open. Anything there? No. A white. Okay. Right. I know I opened these two out here, so I'm just going to check them first. Nope. Right, a couple more reds and there should be another crimson lance chest in here as well. Yep, there we go. Mass open everything. I'm going to need to cough in a second. Excuse me. Okay. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. That was shocking. Okay, more purples, nothing here. I thought that was a legendary then when I actually saw the orange text, but it wasn't. Right, I think we can move on out. Yeah, there's nothing else here. Right, so to this part here then. Why isn't that opening? Oh, there you go, it just didn't show up. So, have I opened all the chests I can around here? I think I have. Yes, right. So, now we're going to go across here and open these two. What we got? Nothing. Right, fair enough. I'm not bothered. Can I go up here? What's up? Oh, yes, I want it to be down here. I want it to be down here onto the lower levels first before I go to the upper levels. So there's, it's because I was on the elevator and I should have gone down the middle. Damn it. Oh well, there's loads more over here. Nope, nothing there. Fair enough. Right, back down to this part then. There's loads around here and then we've got one final part at the very top and then we're going to head to Borderlands 2 and pick up some easy points. Don't look like there's anything there. Nope, right. We'll open that and that. Won't bother with them. We don't need white chests. I really should open the white chests while I'm here, but I just hate white chests. Hate them. Nope, nothing there. Have I got all of the ones yet? That's the first room we went to, and there's the elevator. So, got this little part down here, and then one more part up the top, and we'll just open every single chest we can here. Why not? Don't want to miss anything. Look at this sheer amount of chests in here, it's unreal. Why can't they have brought this back for a pre-sequel or even in Borderlands 2? Would have been a nice way to just do some endgame farming, but it was a bit OP really, the amount of chests you could actually open and the amount of legendaries you could just pull out of one run sometimes. But we're getting a bit scarce on the old legendaries here. I'm not bothered, I have a pearl! Wow, I still can't get over that. Oh, there we go, another legendary. So we've got a Hunter Striker. Nice, so that's a Jacobs. Jacobs Striker, 2 more points. 23 points already, guys. We are killing it. Killing it. Let's just have a little look at that. Sniper rifles are for chumps, yeah. I see, I love the red text in Borderlands 1. That's dark orange as well, which means it's rarer, I think. I don't know if... I'm pretty sure, yeah. You get dark orange and light orange in this game. The light orange ones are quite common legendaries, and the dark ones are a bit rarer. I believe that's true anyway. Correct me if I'm wrong, guys. Nothing here. No. And, yep, there we go. Boom, boom, boom. Last couple of chests here, and then we're off up top. I've already checked them. Right, no. Is that an alien weapon? Yes, it is. That's an iridium lightning. I believe we've already got one of them, though, so we cannot do that, unfortunately. We cannot count that. Okay, right, I think we're ready to go up to the top. Oh, oranges everywhere. Oranges everywhere. Right, last little part. There's quite a few Crimson Lance chests up here. And then it's time to get over to Borderlands 2. And, yeah, I think we'll just go... I might actually go for... I was going to go and get a load of easy blues in this episode, but I might just try and farm the... See, if I was in Borderlands 2, then that would have killed me. But luckily, Borderlands 1, you can just glitch through the thing coming down on your head. Right, so we're really right to the top now. But yeah, I think I might just end this with a tree ant bee farm, actually. Get another good chunk of points. And then next episode, we will we'll just go around and get a load of blues. I think I'm going to go to Southpaw Seaman Power, farm the assassins, things like that. Captain Flint, get his tinderbox, and just get a nice couple of ones and twos. Try and get the easy ones, pick them up. And every point counts, really. We've got a lot of catching up to do, but I'm sure we'll get quite a few. We'll never get up to what some people are at. Some people are, I think there's a total of 1,000 points in total. And I think some people are at like 800 already, so there's not much left to do. But obviously they're going to be stuck farming things like the Cobra and the Sham for a long time. So while they're doing that, we can possibly catch up a little bit. Okay, right, last couple of Crimson Lance chests here. Hopefully we can get some good loot in here. The Crimson Lance chests, for those of you that don't know, provide the best loot in the game, really, and that's where the pearlescence come from. So I think we've got them all now. Yes, right, let's go check, see if we've got him. No, nothing there. The chances of getting another pearl are like 0.01%, I think, in certainly with my luck. And yeah, I believe that's it then. Okay, so we are absolutely rocking it with a good start. Episode 1, we have a pearlescent weapon, which I'm claiming is pretty damn rare. So, yeah, that's good. That is the armory run anyway. Plenty of points. We've got about 23 now. So, let's go over to Borderlands 2 and get ourselves a nice bee. I think that'll be good. So, right, I'll see you guys in a second. Okay, we're back and we are in Borderlands 2 now. So, the first thing I want to do before doing a bee farm is actually come into the dust and seeing if we can get the Gwen's head very quickly. Now, it shouldn't take too long. It appears in a box just down here, I believe. One of them boxes there, and it should appear just here. So, if we're quitting out and coming back in, then eventually, after about 5 runs maybe maximum, it will actually it'll actually do it. So, we'll go do that, and then we'll see if we can get a bee from the tree ant. So I'm going to spend about no more than 10 minutes doing everything. If we don't get it, we don't get it. We'll do it in the next episode. If we do, we do. Fair enough. So, here we go. Let's see if we can get a nice Gwen's head. That will be one easy point. I know it sounds weird. It's only 1 point, but it's 1 point better than what we could do, and you've literally got to do nothing. All you have to do is spawn in, open the box, and Gwen's head is yours. So, this box is going to be a troll now and not appear for me, though. It shouldn't take that long to actually do it. Shouldn't take that long in theory, but you know, my luck sometimes is not very good. Oh, what are you doing? What are you doing? I thought my internet went down then. Normally it's instant, but maybe having a bit of trouble with the old internet today if it's going to take that long. Creating an online session. I don't want to be online. I don't play online. Oh, come on, guys. Taking the mic now. You watch, it's just me and I ain't played it in that long. I forgot where the spot is. I'm sure it's just there. I'm sure it's just around that corner. Because the boxes do move sometimes. They're not always the same layout. Come on! You open one of them boxes. It's there. It's definitely got to be there. It has got to be there. I'm sure of it. We'll try a few more times. It's going to be a troll. It's going to be a troll. But we'll do it. We'll find it. If not, we'll go see the tree ants. Ah, well, the blood pool tree ants anyway. I'm not running all the tree ants, but we'll get ourselves a bee pretty easily. And I know a lot of people say RNG is RNG, but, you know, random is random. But them tree ants drop that B quickly. I'm telling you. I am telling you. It's my one thing that I am 100% sure about. Them tree ants. I've never got one in less than 10 runs. So... Oh, Gwen's head, where the hell are you? Why are you trolling me? I'm sure it changes every couple of runs or so. It'll just appear just there. And now it's being a troll. I'm not going to boo this too much longer, you know. One, two, three more tries. Four more tries. Oh, my God. Gwen's head. Where the hell are you? Oh, Borderlands used to be good to me. I think we've run out of luck. We've already had our pearl drop, which I'm still mega happy about. And yeah, the Gwen's head's being a div. No, I'm not having it. It's definitely there. I'm 100% sure it should definitely be there. Stop being a dick. By the way, guys, I am planning on live streaming quite a lot with this series as well. I just thought I'd get up and record an episode today just to kick things off. And, wow, it's just not playing ball today. It is just not playing ball at all. One more try and then sod it. But, yeah, I'm planning on live streaming this a few times. They're not going to be great times, though, I will admit. I'm in the UK and it's normally days I get to record, so it's UK. Maybe afternoon, so for you guys over in the US and things like that, it'll be a really shite time. It'll be like 9-10 in the morning probably, but I will try and do a couple of Sunday evenings now and again, so about 6 o'clock at night maybe, so that'll be about dinner time for the Americans. So yeah, unfortunately that's the times I stream. There we go, Gwen's head, woohoo. See, you just take your thought away from something, and there it goes. So, there's the Gwen's head. Anyway, there's my Sandhawk. And, yep, I'm using a Chaotic Evil Monk. Good. I would like to use the Rocket Jumping Gunzerker, but it's not going to do well against the Tree Ants. So, we are heading to... Where are we heading to? I forgot. It's the Immortal Woods. Or is it the forest? No, it's the Immortal Woods going back into the forest. Right, little speed farm going on here then. So, we are after the beast. That's another point for us, by the way. So, I believe, if my totals are correct, we are on 24 already. And, like I said, I'm not going to spend too long doing this. If we don't get them in a few runs, we'll kick off the next episode farming these. And then we'll go get a load of blues. So, we'll go to the Assassins, Captain Flint, things like that, like I said. I could actually farm... Could we actually farm an ogre here? I can't remember if you can farm the ogre here. Well, we're going to leave all these guys well alone anyway. And literally just go after tree ants. Just go after the tree ant. Now, I can't remember my little tactic. Do I use... I think I do use my unkempt tarot. I don't think you can do very well with a... oh, God. While I'm here, my gameplay. Is it gameplay? Or will it be video? I think it'll be video. Yes, right. Let me tell you my... hood, cause that's not fitting to the screen right now. Is that better? I think that's better. There we go. We can actually see what's going on here. Right, let's go spawn some tree ants in then. Hello, sirs. Now these shoot things back at you, so I'm going to hide behind here. Yes, that's how we do it. There's one tree ant down. Can't see a bee. It's normally the second tree ant that will give us the bee. Can we get lucky again today? Oh god, forgot about them little orbs, should have waited. Don't see any orange there. No. Well, I didn't expect one in our first run anyway. Excuse me, so we'll quit out. Now, what is the B? The B from Hunter, Hellquist or Treant is 5 points. So that's 5 nice, lovely points. Are you being serious? The sham is only 6 points? Are you being serious? Wow. The sham is only 6 points, guys. That is bad. That should be more, surely. Ow! Well, that hurt. Well, let's hope... I was just about to say, should I Gunzerk, but I didn't. Well, that's my fault. And I can actually Gunzerk in Fight for Your Life, can't I? Am I going to die here? No, am I hell. I never die. Heroes never die. Right, well, we are screwed here. We might actually go down again. Nope, we're alright. Come on, get some of that quick beat. Oi! We're trying to speed farm here. Whoa. Grog, you can sod off. Let's just hammer that Gunzerk. Come on. Grog, down, please. We are trying. Oh, God. We are trying. Why are you so powerful? Or am I just so bad? Come on. Oh, we might go down here. We might go down here. Nope, he's down. Ha, sucker. Right. I've not got a lot of health, though, so I might health... might health farm this guy a little bit. There we go. And then we've got our bee back. Let's get him down with the... There we go. Wait for the orbs to sod off, or they're going to hurt us. There we go, second chance. Ow! What the hell's that? What the hell is that? I am annoyed a fairy, have I? Well, we've got no bee here. Ow, right, I should have got my bee. Damn it. I should have got my Gunzerk on the go. Well, we'll get the tree ant down anyway. Hopefully. There we go. Wow, that was not a good farm at all. I'm going to learn from that, though. Yep, there's no bee there, is there? Oh, god damn it. Sodding fairies. I hate them. Well, the first run you saw a perfect example of bee farming, and the second run you just saw a complete and utter fail. Let's make it a good farm this time, please. I should really take some of these guys out, but I just can't be bothered. You just run past them. And wow, it's so hard to stop, not glide like you do in the pre-sequel. I keep double tapping spacebar. Oh god. Wow, down again already. That is not good. Well, let's just try and avoid... Oh my god. It's because I'm doing it on overpower 8 as well. I think it's a bit of a pain. Well, you guys can go away. Let's just YOLO this run then. If they're going to follow me up here, we'll just wait for them, I think. Yeah, let's wait for them. Come on then. May as well get him down. We're in no rush, my friend. Let's try and get that money shot on him. And I'm out of ammo. Wow. Perfect timing. Should have got some ammo. I'm not... Oh, just go away, my friend, please. Just go away. I need that bee shield. Oh, God, the tree ant's out as well. Oh, for God's sake, just leave me alone, Grog. Jesus, no, I'm not having this. Sorry to quit, guys, but that is just... Ugh. I need some ammo. Come on. No, please. Here we go, then. Here we go. That's one guy down. Ha ha. Because I'm free to do what I want. Any old time. Let's get a magic missile shot on these. Try and push him back a little bit. There we go. That should keep him occupied for a little bit. Leaving B to get them to despawn up here. Well, not despawn, just lose aggression. But it don't look like they are. It looks like just standing over there. Oh, God. Move out of the way. Don't get me orbs. Don't get me orbs. Nothing dropped by the first one. Let's see if we can get some luck with the second one. There we go. There's orange. There's orange, baby. Ha ha. See, tree ants. Love them. Overpower 6, it doesn't matter. We have a bee. And I believe that is 5 extra points. 5 points for the bee. There we go. Nice, nice, nice. Right, I'm going to go kick the living crap out of some orc circus now. Because they have been a pain in my backside for a long time. Okay, well, there you go, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. It's been a load of fun going back to Borderlands 1, starting out in the armory, and then coming to Borderlands 2, and doing the good old bee farm. So, like I said, I'm pretty sure I'll total it up and let you guys know in the next episode, but I'm pretty sure we're on 29 points after the first episode. So, yeah, like I said, I'm going to start doing some more live streams soon as well for you guys, so you can actually watch me and help me and just chat to me, really. So that's twitch.tv/00TheMessiah00. It's on... it's in the description anyway. And also keep an eye, add me on Twitter if you've got Twitter, because I'll put when I'm live streaming on there as well. And yeah, so thanks for watching, everyone. Hope you've enjoyed the hunt, and hopefully we can get some more points in the next coming weeks. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys soon in a live stream or in the next episode. Bye, everyone.